Well, joining us now, Reverend Leo Cornelio, the Archbishop of Bhopal, President of the Council of Bishops of Madhya Pradesh. Reverend, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Just a very basic question first. Were any of the teachers or students in that school hurt?
I don't think the teachers and students were hurt, but the damage has been done to the school and to the property.
Reverend, is it true that school authorities had received a letter warning of an impending attack? This had been brought to the light of the police, and yet this still took place?
I have heard that way. Yes, there was already an earlier information that they are going to do some worship or some puja. But then later on, this attack came all of a sudden in the context of the first communion and confirmation they had in the church, and that was somehow shown in the video. And then they said that one they said was conversion efforts going on that account. That was on the 6th of December, and actually the communion and so on took place on the 31st of October. So on the 6th of December they did the attack.
Archbishop, the allegation of conversion, we'll talk about the larger allegation across Madhya Pradesh in a moment. But as I understand it, none of the students who were apparently converted even studied in this school. Is that right?
Correct. You're right. We have thousands of students studying in different schools, and there is no question of converting them. What we are trying to give them is a really character building and moral values, which are very essential for nation building. And this is considered as sort of conversion. And this is all a bogey, just a kind of, allegation, and then only to polarize the situation and some kind of gain for those vested interests, parties. I don't see any reality or any truth in it. Sometime back, I gave an interview already saying, for years now, you are saying that Christians are resorting to conversion. Last 30 years have not shown any increase in the percentage of Christian population.
Yes.
How come that there is so much conversion going on, and while the number is not showing, and there is no indication of any increase. And then hundreds of thousands of students are studying in India who are going through the portals of our schools. How come that these people are not converted? How many of them are getting converted? How many are able to accuse us that we are converting them, even preaching them any gospel? But values we definitely give, values of all religions, where every religion teaches peace, love, and brotherhood, sisterhood. And this kind of teaching cannot be considered as only the Catholic or Christian teaching. It is the value of all religions. And why should it be that some religious fanatics resort to such violence in the name of religion in order to create a havoc, create fear, and create polarization? That is the biggest question. And who are the agents who are doing that? The people who are attacking, I believe, are not the ones. There are some others sitting far away, higher up in their offices, and directing these things, I believe.
Archbishop, that is why. Is it true that in October as well, there was a school in Madhya Pradesh which was served an ultimatum, apparently by the Bajrang Dal, to install an idol of Goddess Saraswati or else? Is that something that took place?
Right, right. They said that some years back there was an idol and they were worshipping. All that is false. There is no history of this sort, and they just wanted to make it a kind of story, and then they wanted to say, all right, we are giving an ultimatum by such and such time, you have to install that statue. Of course, action was taken and it did not happen. But then these threats are really instilling fear in the school, in the administration, and then the peace and harmony is disturbed. And on that account, the whole teaching and whole administration becomes a big problem, because it is not going to be peaceful with this kind of threat? And why should these anti-social elements get involved in the portals of these holy portals of schools and education?
What is this a part of? Because it's not just the two school incidents that we've spoken about. There have been various other attacks in Uttarakhand, in Uttar Pradesh, and two in Madhya Pradesh just since the month of October alone. We've seen many attacks being reported in Karnataka as well, and this bogey of conversion. So what is this a part of? These are not standalone incidents.
I believe that it is a political effort to polarize, pleasing certain groups in the name of religion. I believe that. Otherwise, there is no reason why the government cannot take action against such elements. They allow things to happen. They are just spectators for some time, and after everything has happened, they move in.
Yeah.
Quite often it happens.
Yeah.
They don't act on time, and damage is done, and news passes on. And besides, all these things they are recording and uploading and showing their kind of triumph, which is not right at all.
It's very
not
sad.
At all.
It's very sad.
In a democratic country, such things should not happen, because all religions are to be treated equally. We have these constitutional rights to practice and preach our own religion, and conversion is not our business, not human effort. It is God's grace, we believe, and nobody should be any way by inducement or force should be converting anyone to any religion.
And that's the bottom line. Forcible conversion is illegal. It's out of the question. Members of the Christian community are not involved in that, is what you say. And you have statistics to suggest that the percentage of Christians has been going down, and that it's not tenable to actually make these allegations.
Yes.
Well, joining us
this now,
sure.
Others convert, they call it ghar wapasi. That again is wrong.
All right. Archbishop, I take the point, and you've made very strong points, and I'd like to thank you.